Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Our Lady of the Sacred Heart Cathedral. As we celebrate the 12th Sunday of Ordinary Time, please stand and join in singing from the Catholic Book of Worship, number 650. This Day God Gives Me. This day God gives me strength of high heaven, sun and moon shining, flame in my heart, flashing of lightning, wind in its swiftness, deeps of the ocean, firmness of earth. This day God says,
and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
And a welcome to everybody on this Father's Day Sunday. And so we pray in a special way at Mass for our fathers living and dead. And a welcome to our people that can gather. And in Manitoba now, there is the groups of 50 that can be gathered in the church. And if there's extra space, even a little beyond that. So as we pray, Lord, we ask for your forgiveness. And we'll ask for the Lord have mercy in Cree today. Manitou ki ti ma ki na wi nan. Manitou ki ti ma ki na wi nan. Sezus kiti makina winan. Sezus kiti makina winan. Manitou kiti makina winan. Manitou ki ti ma ki na wi nan. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Have mercy on us. You take
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm on the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
And we have our readings.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Jeremiah cried out, "I hear many whispering. Terror is all around. Denounce him. Let us denounce him. All my close friends are watching for me to stumble. Perhaps he can be enticed, and we can prevail against him and take our revenge on him. But the Lord is with me like a dread warrior. Therefore, my persecutors will stumble, and they will not prevail. They will be greatly shamed, for they will not succeed. Their eternal dishonor will never be forgotten. O Lord of hosts, you test the righteous. You see the heart and the mind. Let me see their retribution upon them. For to you I have committed my cause. Sing to the Lord, praise the Lord. For he has delivered the life of the needy from the hands of evildoers." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm can be found in the Catholic Book of Worship, number 145.
In your great love, answer me, O God. In your great love, answer me, O God.
It is for you that I suffer taunts, that shame covers my face, that I have become a stranger to my family, an alien to my own brothers and sisters. I burn with zeal for your house, and taunts against you fall on me. In your great love, answer me. This is my prayer to you, my prayer for your favor. In your great love, answer me, O God, with your help that never fails. Lord, answer, for your love is kind. In your compassion, turn towards me. In your great love, answer me, O God. The poor, when they see it, will be glad, and God-seeking hearts will revive. For the Lord listens to the needy and does not spurn his servants in their chains. Let the heavens and the earth give him praise, the sea and all its living creatures. In your great love, answer me, O God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, just as sin came into the world through one man, and death came through sin, so death spread to all people because all have sinned. Sin was indeed in the world before the law, but sin is not reckoned when there is no law. Yet death, exercised dominion from Adam to Moses, even over those whose sins were not like the transgression of Adam, who is a type of the one who was to come. But the free gift is not like the trespass. For if the many died through the one man's trespass, much more surely has the grace of God and the free gift in the grace of one man, Jesus Christ, abounded for the many. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Spirit of truth will testify on my behalf, says the Lord, and you walk so long to testify. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
We have a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus summoned the 12 and sent them out with the following instructions. Have no fear, for nothing is covered up that will not be uncovered, and nothing secret that will not become known. What I say to you in the dark, tell in the light. And what you hear whispered, proclaim from the rooftops. Do not fear those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. Rather fear him who can destroy both body and soul in hell. Are not two sparrows sold for a penny? Yet not one of them will fall to the ground apart from your Father. And even the hairs of your head are all counted. So do not be afraid. You are of more value than many sparrows. And everyone, therefore, who acknowledges me before others, I also will acknowledge before my Father in heaven. But whoever denies me before others, I also will deny before my Father in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So as the bishop mentioned at the beginning, that this weekend we celebrate Father's Day. Now, technically, Father's Day is not a religious feast, but on the other side, it is. Because every Sunday, we celebrate in honor of the Father, God the Father. And so, the good news for us is that every weekend is Father's Day. Jeremiah, in the first reading tonight, is very much aware that his prophecy is getting him into some deep trouble, i.e., death. There are grumblings. People don't like the message. And so he certainly understands that the opposition is ready to strike. I'm hoping that that fate isn't going to fall me tonight. One of the things that really comes to my mind when we speak about fathers is God the Father created all things, none of which he ever rejected or resented, but all is good and all is well. And for each one of us, he manifests, you know, that we, you and I, are created in the image and the likeness of God. And he delights in all of us, not some of us, all of us. And so what has gone wrong over the centuries that we have such a problem acknowledging our self-worth, every one of us? And how do I get this place where I can point my finger at people and say, not you? Somehow or other, God doesn't love you. Certainly, you're not his image and likeness. And we're seeing the fruits of that these days, and all of the protestations about violence, Black Lives Matter. And you know what's true? Black lives do matter. So indigenous lives matter. So do white people matter. There is no limit to the lives that really matter. It's all of us. And somehow or other, we need to find a way to turn the tide, and so that we can recognize the goodness of all, and that we could depart from this whole thing of racism. As I reflected on the readings, the things that were coming to me is that, first of all, I need to take some ownership in my own life of attitudes and what have you that are racist. I am judging a people, making conclusions about their net worth. For out of what? Well, certainly in the message of Jesus, we are never to condemn or to judge. That's not our place. And yet we do. And so one of the things I think we need to recognize in all of this is, am I a racist? You know, do I point my finger at others and question their validity? And the answer is yes, I do that. And that's not something of which I'm proud of, but I do that. And I think it's important that we do discover, you know, those ways in which push forward this whole thing of I'm better than you. I've had experiences of attitudes that we could call racist in my own life. I grew up, for a large part, not in the Paw, on the Paw stage of my life, but I lived in a town that was entirely Protestant. The Catholic community there was very, very small. And that was a hardship. Every time I went go to school, we get teased, you know. And of course, it didn't help that we went to church and what have you, and so that increased it. But there was always that sense, you know, that you didn't fit in, that you weren't really welcome here, you know. And, you know, we saw all sorts of things. So I was telling somebody, you know, the church, the Catholic church was a shack. And so they're with the joining together of the United or Methodists and the Presbyterians, which forms the United Church of Canada, they had an empty building for sale. And so the Catholic community bought this church. It was a nice church, kind of roundish. And well, somebody went in and took the floor out. No Catholic needs a hardwood floor, you know. Well, I didn't know that you could deconstruct the place, you know, before people take occupancy. But that was kind of the attitudes, and it affects everybody. A few years ago, I was attending a Rosaire House had sent me down to for training at Hazelden. And after this thing was over, coming home, I had to spend the night in Minneapolis, and I did so with another pastor, a black man. He was a delight to be with. And we went out for supper together. Got in this restaurant, you know. The waitress refused to give us service. They would serve me, but they would not serve him. You know? I hurt for the man. You know, he did nothing. But somehow or other, you know, we get this attitude that, you know, the whole race is somehow or other rotten to the core. But now we don't know. We have to determine whose core is really rotten. I would like to propose that somehow or other that we're able to turn the tide of all of this negativity, you know, being stereotyping, you know, speaking ill of others, you know, and I'm just as guilty as anybody for doing it. But it's wrong. It is simply wrong. And racism is wrong. And it'll never be made right unless you and I find a better way of being brothers and sisters. One of the realities, like for years, you know, we kind of, you know, we talk about the Jews, you know, being the chosen people, and fine. But it never enters our mind that, certainly not theirs, that he can choose some others as well. You know, we're all chosen people. God created us. You know, and we need to live that out. It's all the Catholic Church, you know. Only Catholics in heaven. You know, that's the only way that if you're not this, you're out. Well, that's not so sure. And so let us kind of reflect and recognize those ways in which we have hurt others. Part of our reconciliation and truth and so on is coming to acknowledge, you know, the harm that we have done, whether it was deliberate or not, No? And we can seek forgiveness. But the other side has also done that to us as well. And so there's a mutual coming together and an acknowledgement that, yes, we have sinned against one another. And now I wish to embrace you in the name of God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Confess our faith together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. And we bring to God our prayers of the faithful again today, especially lifting up all our fathers.
Response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church and all those who witness to Christ in the face of rejection, ridicule, or danger, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a fair distribution of the world's resources, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the chronically ill and all those who suffer physically, emotionally, and or mental pain, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our fathers today, in gratitude for their love and care for their families, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish community, striving to bring God's love to those who, with whom we live and work, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We pray as well for Agnes St. Pierre of Lac Brochet, who passed away, for her and all her family at this time, and for all the grieving. We pray to the Lord. Almighty God, Kitsamanato, we ask for your positive grace to be at work in this COVID time and time of riots. May there be positive awareness and systemic change. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our offertory hymn can be found in the Catholic Book of Worship, number 481, Be Not Afraid.
Cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see the face of God and live. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you
pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and the good of all God's holy church. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that cleansed by its action, we make an offering of a heart pleasing to you. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that you sent your mercy, in mercy your Redeemer, to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son Jesus, by whose obedience we have been restored to these gifts of yours, that by sinning we had lost in our unfaithfulness. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. Indeed, holy, Kitsumanato, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Se adarie ni Jesus Jesus nu ha slaideru nachi daio hinait ni hel du hare bezichu bedelachu nu ha honde la na nala na dathlio na ba honzo a galeri daha nu gena tzit a marsi na yenidensi. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis our Pope, myself your unworthy servant, and all who serve your people. Remember all the fathers who have passed away, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that they who are united with Jesus in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that together with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Now pray together for our dads and all our society in the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await with blessed hope the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And in a COVID-safe way, let us share Christ's peace with one another.
Our communion hymn can be found in the Glory and Praise, number 598, on Eagle's Wings. Glory and Praise, 598.
the Lord, who abide in his shadow for love. Say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock, in whom I trust. Then he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. The snare of the fowler will never capture you, and famine will bring you no fear. Under his wings your refuge, his faithfulness your shield, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. You need not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day, though thousands fall about you. Shall not come, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. And
renewed and nourished by the precious sacred body and blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. And I'd ask the fathers to please come forward. All the fathers, if you could please come towards the front of the church. And we invite you fathers at home to please stand in your home now. And all the rest of you that are here, I invite you to sort of raise your hands and I'll pray a blessing on all these dads. Father Jim, you better get down there too. And so we pray for all our fathers at this moment now and for all those fathers that are watching at home. God, our Father, we praise you and bless you for the life you have given us through your serving love revealed in Jesus your Son. Through Christ you have revealed yourself as a loving Father who provides for us all. Look with love upon all of these fathers. Bless them with your love. Deepen their love for their wives and families, and make them one in love with all your holy people as we will proclaim your mighty deeds and sing your praises. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And let us show our appreciation of our dads that are here. And so please return to your places. A special Happy Father's Day to my own dad. And that we celebrate the importance of having good men. We often talk about the women and their strength and graces, but in our society, we often put the guys down a lot. But we need good men. Faithfulness. When men choose to come to Mass, when men choose to pray with their families, it's a very big, rich gift for their families. When a man seeks to be honest and protective of those needing protection. It's living out the gift of who we are as men. So we pray for those graces and courage and honesty to be part of our men here in our church. The Lord be with you.
And with you.
And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace to love and serve our Lord. Thanks be to God.
Please join in singing from the Catholic Book of Worship, number 447, A Living Faith.
Faith of our fathers living still, in spite of dungeon, fire, and sword. Oh, how our hearts beat high with joy whenever we hear that glorious song.